some of the consortium conferences. And many of you know that I also teach for the consortium. I teach communication courses. And along that lines, I have been speaking with Gretchen Bartelson, also with the consortium, and we would like to create an alternate reality game that is the foundation for a course with the consortium. Let me explain. For a long time, we've known the power of curriculum integration. Habitable Worlds really showed very well that science, especially science for non-majors, is a much stronger experience when you combine all of the sciences rather than just using earth science in a vacuum or biology in a vacuum. When you combine all the sciences together, it really helps create that contextual platform for students to understand better and more. Well, we've also seen that an alternate reality game can do the same thing. It's an excellent way to create a foundational immersive event that you can tie multiple disciplines to in such a way that it is contextual and really helps the students retain better, faster, longer. It really helps them with some critical thinking. It helps them with some communication skills. It helps them with a lot of things. It's very much like the Mystery at MIT course that some of you are familiar with, where over two weekends, foreigner students are essentially asked to uncover a problem and then to solve that problem. But they come at it from very different angles. They come at it as nurses. They come at it as chemists. They come at it as political scientists. They act as the administration of the school. They act as engineers consulting with the school. They really do approach the problem very differently, even though it's all the same event. We would like to try to do that with the consortium. About 17 years ago, I had the opportunity to build a class called Communication in the Courtroom. And what we did was we got about 250 students who, over a couple of weekends, we gave them the theory they needed to understand how a courtroom worked, how you communicated with a judge, with a defense attorney, how you were a good witness, etc. And then the second weekend of the course was based on a murder. That's actually me. I had just been murdered in that picture. And so the students, after the murder took place, were put into their teams, their groups, their clusters, and they began the trial. They started interviewing people. They started doing their research. Then they presented their findings as different members of the trial. That included some mechanical aspects that we had to build, myself and some of the other instructors who were involved. We had to create blood spatter photos and slides, and we created evidence that they actually used. We created narratives and plot elements for the students as well. That narrative really was the ribbon that tied the whole thing together and allowed the students to really come together with one cohesive story that they would explore based on their particular subject matter. They all eventually had a different part to play, a different role to play, whether it was a person who was watching, researching, acting, interacting, whatever it might be. It was really quite the experience. So when it comes to us at the consortium, this is something we would like to try to build. We are thinking of trying to do this the second 8-week set of courses in fall of 2013. It would involve a lot of front-loaded course information. The hybrid experience would really be the online stuff happening over the beginning of that semester, culminating in a one weekend, 18-hour event in Des Moines. We would also have a couple of live webinars throughout the process where we would gather all of the students together and those sorts of things. But essentially, the idea is for us all to begin teaching together in separate pieces, and then come together in November to approach the problem from our various perspectives. Therefore, we need you. We have some big shoes to fill, and we think that you are just the instructors to do it. Some people who want to play this game in such a way that it helps your students understand and learn better. What that means is that you've got folks like myself and Gretchen who are creating some resources, some assets, facilitation and strategy, but we would be using your help as instructional designers and media technicians and instructors of whatever discipline to actually teach the courses to groups and students so that we all have this immersive experience together. We will use an alternate reality game template to begin to build this experience from top down, from the big goals down to the smaller outcomes and objectives. And we will actually need your help in building that framework, in crafting the clues, in identifying what it means for a student to perform well, effectively, for the final tasks to be accomplished. The programs or classes that we're interested in is really up to you. In the past, at University of Northern Colorado and at Metro State, I had the opportunity to work with some journalism teachers, some psychology teachers, legal studies and forensic science, those sorts of groups. But it really is anyone who feels that you can tie your subject matter to this particular experience. In fact, one program we would be very interested in might be programming. We would like to figure out if this isn't something we could turn into an app or something like that to make it a really great replicable experience for anybody. But if you feel that you might be able to tie your class to a courtroom experience, whether it's mass communication, photojournalism, medicine, nursing, pre-law, pre-med, legal studies, any of those sorts of things, and anything else that we haven't even thought of, we would like your input. So what does that mean for you? Well, you would have to identify a course that tied back up to this global experience. And again, that could really be just about anything. You'll have to help us market it a bit on your campus. We'd like to get the students excited about this, to get them pumped up and jazzed about this experience. We have some marketing materials and things we're going to be providing as well, but we would like your help on individual campuses. Of course, you'll need to identify the outcomes and objectives that are specific to your course that actually tie back to the alternate reality game. We will need your help in laying the foundation, the framework for this whole experience. We will need help in participating in the game or the course as it goes. And then, of course, that means coming to Des Moines with us. There will be meetings that we will have regularly, but that also means the two live experiences for the students. And then we'll need to, again, tie it back to assessment for the local as well as the global experience with the different students in their groups as individuals, however that looks. And then finally, we will need your help in understanding what assets need to be involved in this game so it does tie correctly and effectively to your course. And those assets can be any number of things, from text to websites to actual physical clues, all kinds of things that will tie back to some of the outcomes we will create, what we're calling global outcomes. And these are outcomes that have already been established. They're around the civics elements, elements of persuasion, elements of courtroom process, etc. But we will then need your help tying them to your local outcomes, to your specific course, so that your students are getting what it is that you feel they need to get to have accomplished an effective and efficient Psych 101 or Journalism 110 or whatever the course might be. We will need your help creating the narrative, creating the different stakeholders and roles and role types and actors and what that looks like. And all of that, I think, should lead to a tremendous experience. So when I answer the question of why, I think this is going to be a tremendous amount of fun from both a learning and a teaching perspective. I think we will get to work with a group of rock star teachers, sort of a dream team of teachers, if you will, people who are really trying to be innovative and creative, but at the same time really care passionately and deeply about education. And so I would encourage you, when the applications come out, to answer this question: would you like to play a game? With a yes. The applications are being formulated right now. You can get more information from your distance learning coordinator, but that's probably who the application will actually be coming from, possibly Gretchen Bartelson. But I really hope that you will consider playing this game with us and setting up an experience for tremendous, immersive, situated learning with your students in a way that is unique and, I think, going to be a good time. Thanks for your time, and I hope to see and talk with many of you soon.